$1,000. I'm waiting on some other junk. We're going to go back and revisit some songs that I know in stereo in the headphone world are going to be fucking spectacular. And a lot of them are going to be surprise songs. They're all obviously going to be repeats of previous versions or previous episodes. But nonetheless, multiple fuck yeahs should be occurring throughout the entire experience due to the, you know, stereo experience. So, today, that's all you're getting. We're just going to give you that. That's what we're doing today. We're going to do Tub Thumping from Chumbawamba's 8th album, Tub Thumping. 3.2 million copies sold in the United States of America. Produced by the band. They disbanded in 2012 after 30 years of being together. Huge career. This was a number one throughout the entire world. They formed in 1982 after being in Chimps Eat Bananas, one of the worst band names of all time. They were always a communal setup. They did what we call agit-pop, which is, pop that is agit. After years of indie success, they signed to EMI in 1997, which made them financially viable. Before this song existed, the band were in a bad way. Directionalist and disparate, according to Dunstan, who credits it with bringing them all back together. It's about the resilience of ordinary people inspired by being at their local pub, the Ford Gree. Ah, my fucking handwriting. I don't know why I even make cards sometimes. Anyway, it's a famous music venue. The Sex Pistols, U2, the Dire Straits, and Simple Minds that all played there. The band has 8 members in it. And this song, put your fucking headphones on, because it's so good. The fidelity is amazing. The performances are incredible. The surprises are surprising. It's everything you want in a session and more. We're going to start with the drum department, which is Harry Daz Hamer, who does the drumming. They all kind of chip in on the old percussion-y bits. But listen to this fucking drum take. Put your headphones on, man. Here we go. Headphones, this should be a world. How many buckets are being hit? Can't be in a bad mood. Little frigga ding dunk dick a gunk. It's almost like an old school go-go beat with an attitude problem. So this is, during the trumpet solo part, the beat gets even deeper because suddenly it has this like fucking thing happening. Ready? like, so fucking sick. Oh man. Knock myself out. Where to put things? I don't have a floor anymore. All right, so that's our drum track. Preposterous. So much fucking work going on. There's drum loops. There's real drums playing. There's fucking toms. There's fucking all sorts of little strummed big. I mean, you can actually hear it now in the fucking, you know. You can hear it in the headphones. It's amazing. It's going all over the fucking place, right? All right, so now we get to the bass, which is a keyboard placed by Paul Greco plays this, by all accounts. And this is the first of the big surprises. So we're just going to let it play. It's very simple. We're just going to let it do what it has to do. And then I'm going to bring the drums in, and then you're going to go, what? That the bass has been backwards the entire time. You were hearing it do a thing, and then it wasn't doing that thing. It was doing a thing against the thing that you thought there was a thing that it was doing. So on its own again, it does this. You thought it was doing another thing the whole fucking time. I know, the first time we did this, it was bonkers. So if you start the song, we'll do it this way. We're going to start the song, let the drums play, and then I'm going to bring the bass in. Ready? So much smart. We'll be right back. so sick in the headphones. So sick of the fucking headphones. Speaking of which, is anyone in the chat? I have to put tape over the number, so I don't know how many people are here. But is anyone in the chat currently utilizing Bose noise canceling headphones of any variety, or any Beats? Let's just see. Before we move on to the keyboards department. Oh, by the way, the percussion is played by the brilliant Alice Nutter. Alice Nutter, who was on Politically Incorrect, and when she was on Politically Incorrect, the Bill Maher show back in the day, she told everybody to steal the record. So, all right. So, The Revolution 78, you're on Beats. You're on Bose. Yep, fuck that. Leanne Tix, you're on Bose. Fuck that. E-Momeni. Okay. Kurditz. All right, we're going to do this. Kurd Tiz, Leon Tix in Texas, and the Revolution 78. The three of you need to fucking message me your fucking addresses because your headphones are bullshit. And I'm going to send you a pair of the official headphones of the session, which are Sony MDR7506s. Real headphones for real listening because those things are trash. Okay? So that's what you're going to do. You're going to send me your address in the Chattosaurusness and three pairs of fucking headphones going out today because those are shit and you shouldn't be listening to this show on shit. You'd be better off with a fucking pair of fucking tin cans with some fucking string attached to them and do it that way. For fuck's sakes, man. Oof. Not doing it. Not on my fucking watch. Bose noise-canceling headphones. Jesus Christ. Just wrap a fucking blanket around your head and put a pair of speakers on either side, all right? So there we go. Send me your addresses. Doing three fucking headphones. Bose. Beats. Come on now, people. Get up on this shit. All right, so we're now going to move on to the keyboards department, which is Dan Burt. No Bacon. Not really his name. Real name, Nigel Hunter. Hello, I'm Nigel Hunter. Dan Burt, No Bacon, obviously willing to guess that he is probably the vegan. They're all vegan, but he's definitely a vegan. Keyboards, stereo. Let's do this. People, party, people. Just listen. Hear how that's doing its magic around you? Amazing. This is why I picked it. This and the acoustics. Should be a field around your head. You should feel like you're sitting in a cloud. Mind blown. Here we go. Mm-hmm. sound of unicorn dreams in stereo, everybody. All of that? Come on, man. Drums, it would be a pleasure. That bit, shall we? Oh, man, more fucking trumpets! Right? Come on, this is fucking spectacular. Just the bass and fucking keys alone. What's up, Peanut? Welcome to the new stereo fucking sesh, Peanut. What a thing! Some of that. Straight up Nile up in this bitch with the bass. Little disco fucking guitar from the fucking Agitpops. Here we go. One more time. And now let's put the keys in and let the keys of the guitar. Comes the disco guitar. What a sick melody. Gorgeous. It's fucking gorgeous. so nuanced, man. We haven't even got to the fucking trumplets yet. All right, so that's our extras. A little bit of the guitars, some of the keys, the bass, and the Burning Man drum circle that is the drum circle. So the guitars, we've got Buff Wally. Lou Watts, by the way, is the keyboard player. Good old Lou Watts on keys. Buff Wally on guitars. We start with some of this. Which is basically mocking every single... Somehow they managed to work out a way to mock every single circa 1995 to 2000 song. In it's everything. It's fucking Deep Blue Somethings. It's all of them. It's all of them in one song. That shit is sick. Your headphone experience right now should be bonkers, bonkers bananas. Big old fucking beautiful rich guitars. And then the verse, ready? Little fucking Boston's fucking More Than a Feeling. Yeah, a little Duncan Sheik, Tony Boy. But listen to how good, this is why I picked this. Listen to how gorgeous these hard panned fucking acoustic guitars either side. Just gorgeous. Get the fuck out! With a little fucking chomp, 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 chomp from the electrics. But listen, how gorgeous. This is why I picked it. This is why I picked it. Because of the gorgeousness that is these fucking... You can listen on speakers there, you can listen on headphones, but I'll tell you right now, you can listen on speakers, the first time you put headphones on, you're going to do what everybody who puts headphones on for the first time does and goes, holy fucking shit, I can't believe how fucking unbelievably different this is in headphones. It's an entirely different experience. Adios, Peanut. Love you too, man. Rock that fucking show, son. Can't wait. Am I coming down and seeing you in October? Let's do it. To the chorus. How about this shit? Yes, no three jacks. November is still on. If it wasn't on, you would get an email or you would get a notification through the Instagrams. If you have not received notifications or emails, it is still happening. See you there. November 3rd. No, not November 3rd. November 5th and 6th. November 5th and 6th. With a little disco duck guitars too. Ready some of this? We're going from the top, people, because it's just too good with the fucking The goddamn Simpson is fucking just... Beautiful is this? That's why I had to do it. I had to do it again because you guys never got to hear every single time I would sit here, and this would be happening for me, and I know that what you would be getting was like a flat, condensed, and it was still blowing your fucking minds, and I just knew, like, it's like adding, you know, it's like adding the third person in a threesome. It's just, you know, if it goes right, it is just magic. Takes two, adds one. Possibly one of the stupidest things I've ever said. Love that. I've had both types of threesomes, and I'll be honest with you. It's all chemistry, people. The two dudes, one chick, two chicks, one dude. It basically breaks down to chemistry. Everyone can be hot, everyone can be into it, but if the chemistry ain't there, you might as well just go play fucking Connect Four. All right, so now let's get to the magical bit, okay? We're gonna add in Mavis Maeve Dillon, who plays this. Fucking Maeve. Mavis, to the stage, please. Beautiful. Delay on a trumpet, come on. The ending, she gives a little bit of this action. Now hold on, it's on this track. Amazing performance, Mavis. I don't believe that she is cutting and pasting. I believe that song is Elgar. It's one in England. It's very, very, it's not like the unofficial national anthem. It's a trumpet voluntary. Thank you, Needs Cafe. Needs decaf. Yeah, it's that. It's the. It's sort of like. And if you put the bass in with it, it goes bonkers. With the drums. So now we're going to go from the top with no drums, just keys, synths, acoustics. I'm going to take the bass out for the initial run, too, because it's just so beautiful without it. We're just going to let all of these textures. The fucking crazy thing about this song is it is a fucking bombastic arena anthem. And inside it is this beautifully stacked and coalesced series of subtle, nuanced, fragile choices, except for the big old fucking beefy guitar. Everything else is this gorgeous. It's a series of small things leading up to a big thing. Same could be said of a threesome. It's a bit of a theme, if you know what I'm saying. But nonetheless, this is why I had to do it. Because also, on headphones, it's gorgeous. Thank you. hence why I picked it. Because it really is an extraordinary composition. Chumbawamba, by the way, the reason they're called Chumbawamba is because Chumbas are dudes and Wambas are chicks, and it was a story. One of the people in the band wrote an actual story about Chumbas and Wambas, and the Chumbas are the dudes, Wambas are chicks. So Chumbas and Wambas are dudes and chicks. So we're all Chumbawambas. It's a beautiful composition. And just so you know, so there's a little bit of storytelling going on actually inside the musical choices. So this whole thing of doing the whole, like this bit, right? When it goes into the whole, let's go to this bit. The reason that it's accessing this is because, you know, in England, the sort of like the working class vacation spot is the coast of the fucking Costa del Sol, mate. Let's go to fucking Spain. We're going to go to fucking Spain and hang out. And the song is about the resilience of the working class, basically. So they're sort of taking you on a vacation in the storytelling into this vibe, which is, once again, these acoustics are mic'd and played fucking flawlessly. It's so Boston, it's gorgeous. Listen to how amazing this recording is. You can hear how it's slightly different on either side, so it kind of does a little jang. Oh my god, that's another one that we're gonna have to do. In stereo, the guitar tracks on fucking, if you could only see the way, the guitar tracks on that song are gonna blow your fucking minds, people. Jesus, Christmas cakes. We have so many fucking Tuesdays to do. Listen to this. If you're on either side in your headphones right now, you're hearing two of the most gorgeously recorded guitars I've ever heard. And then we just add the keys. I mean, it's fucking, what is it, 338 to, it's 20 seconds of audio. So much care and respect taken in this 20 seconds of audio, man. This bit. The double up. It's, who's playing the keys? Oh, Dan Burt, no Bacon. Also on guitars. With the guitars. And then finally with Mavis on the old fucking trumpet. All right. Now, the vocals, which are recorded impeccably. Everything is recorded impeccably. Who engineered this record? Can somebody quickly check the old the Wikipedia? And tell me who engineered this fucking... this jam. And the whole thing about we'll be singing when we're winning, obviously, is a soccer reference, right? Like, we'll be singing when we're winning. Trying to see if somebody can find out who engineered this masterpiece. Nobody? Nobody find it? Nobody's got it? Nope. I should have a... I'm gonna need another computer to reference these things. Neil Ferguson, thanks. Basco Productions. Any idea what Neil has done other things? Neil Ferguson. Of course, his fucking name is Neil. Hello. I'm Neil Ferguson. I engineered the fucking Chumbawamba record. All right, so. I think it would be disrespectful of us to not talk during the vocals. Because it's Chumbawamba. And everything they do is a little bit kind of fuck you. And we're hanging out at a pub. We should just listen to these guys. So here's the thing that surprised me about this the first time I did this. The never is we've always imagined that it was like, I get knocked down and I get up again. You're never going to keep me. It's not. The way that they're actually singing never, never going to. They do a never and it's really weird and doesn't actually sound that way when you put it into the song. But once you hear it, you're like, how did I ever not hear that they did this move?
I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down.
Pissing the night away. Pissing the night.
He drinks a whiskey drink, he drinks a vodka drink, he drinks a lager drink, he drinks a cider drink, he sings the songs that remind him of the good times, he sings the songs that remind him of the better times.
Oh, Danny boy, Danny boy, Danny boy.
I get no...
It is ridiculous what the fuck is going on here. So first off, we get...
Pissing the night away.
Because you're pissing the night away because you're at the fucking pub. And it's this beautiful melody. So you do this pissing the night away bit, which just repeats that. And then fucking Dunstan Bruce comes in. Dunstan. And he sings the whole, the verse, which is brilliant.
Pissing the night away. Pissing the night away.
He drinks a whiskey drink. He drinks a vodka.
And then the choice of having this like massive single delay, the feel it's an eighth beat, methinks, just a single delay that repeats and then doesn't.
He drinks a whiskey drink. He drinks a vodka drink. He drinks a lager drink. He drinks a cider drink. He sings the songs that remind him of the good times. He sings the songs that remind him of the better times.
Oh, Danny boy.
And then the other singing is I believe it's Alice Nutter, and it's fucking genius.
He drinks a whiskey drink, he drinks a vodka drink, he drinks a lager drink, he drinks a cider drink, he sings the songs that remind him of the good times, he sings the songs that remind him of the better times.
And then the lyrics are fucking, is a quarter note delay, thank you, Ernie. Then listen to the lyric. It says he sings the songs that remind him of the good times. He sings the songs that remind him of the better times. And then she starts to sing Danny Boy, which if you're in the fucking pub, would be one of the songs that everyone would sing to remind them of the good times and remind them of the better times. The whole thing is so fucking dense.
Pissing the night away. Pissing the night away.
He drinks a whiskey drink. He drinks a vodka drink. He drinks a lager drink. He drinks a cider drink. He sings the songs that remind him of the good times. He sings the songs that remind him of the better times.
Oh, Danny boy, Danny boy, Danny boy.
I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down.
You're never gonna keep me down. Never knew it did that move. So then verse 2.
Piss in the,
same thing.
Piss in the night away.
Well, the reason it's sung to remind you of the good times and the better times is not that the lyrics of the song remind you of the good times and the better times. What reminds you of the good times and the better times was the camaraderie of hanging out with everybody and singing all the songs together, right? And if you're thinking about songs that you could put in that A, are in public domain, and B, would be easily recognizable fucking songs of that ilk, you can't just fucking throw anything in here. So Danny Boy as a choice is beautiful and perfect and also free.
Pissing the night away. Pissing the night away.
He drinks a whiskey drink. He drinks a vodka drink. He drinks a lager drink.
It's the same fucking thing. They've changed nothing until...
He sings the songs that remind him of the good times. He sings the songs that remind him of the better times.
Don't cry for me, next door neighbor.
So the don't cry for me, next door neighbor is... It's weird. A, I don't exactly understand the don't cry for me, next door neighbor thing, but the don't cry for me, Argentina is because the original... not the Madonna version, but the original Don't Cry For Me Argentina was a massive, massive hit in the UK when I was there. And it would fill the pubs with people singing at the top of their fucking lungs. So it's another one of those. But it's a strange choice to go Don't Cry For Me Next Door Neighbor. So they're clearly saying something in that, but they've chosen that for that reason.
Don't cry for me. Next door neighbor.
So when the Evita musical happened, that song was a smash hit. I think it might have gone to number one.
Don't cry for me, next door neighbor.
I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down.
So what's crazy about this gang chorus is that, A, so you can hear that they're doing a loop on it, right? They sampled it and moved it because you can hear the same sort of boot hit on the floor. But how they got this fucking crazy tight Mutt Lang vocal out of it, because I don't think they're using a harmonizer or anything. I believe this is actually, because they were together for 30 years, don't forget. I believe this is actually all of them sort of singing.
I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down.
And this is where it just starts to stack and stack and stack.
I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never
now it just starts to tumble dry.
You're never gonna keep me down. I get knocked down, but I get up again.
only thing they're missing is if I would have done it, I probably would have thrown a, he has a whiskey drink, he has a vodka drink. I would have fucking tossed that in there too. I would have found a way to make that fucking work. All right, so listen to this with the keys. Fucking magic. Amazing. Amazing. I'm not kidding. Absolutely fucking flawless. Flawless song construction. Take it from the bridge with this. Absolutely brilliant. So much melody. Brilliant. Brilliantly executed. God damn it, I love this song. And it's so fucking cool in stereo, man. So fucking cool in stereo. All right. Session's entirely donation-based. If you feel like it, hit the PayPal, which is the website, thesessionwebsite.com, or you can do it through the Venmo, which is Brit Dick, BritDick. See what happens, y'all.
I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me.
Songs that remind him of the better times.
Kiss in the night.
I mean, fucking Stereo Tuesdays are going to be amazing. All right, so that was we're going to do MJ Wednesday tomorrow night. I got to find a specific MJ song. We're going to go back into the fucking catalog and find something that's going to fucking just sing in fucking stereo for sure. What was the there was something that I wanted to check it out. Right. So this has been our anthem forever. And y'all have not fucking heard it. Y'all have not heard it. All you've heard is the fucking shitty condensed fucking, I mean, you don't understand. Like, in order for it to be mono, there was so much fucking fuckery and jiggery pokery going on that the audio that you guys were getting was garbage. It was phasing. It was fucking canceling itself out. It was doing all sorts of shit. Put your fucking headphones on. Listen to this shit now, y'all. Should be caving your fucking skulls in right now. You see what I'm saying? Can you imagine, if you will? I'm going to talk about this until I'm done talking about it, because I don't give a flying fuck. It's my show. It's free. Unless you feel like donating to the Session On Air website, you just go to thesessionwebsite.com, hit the old PayPal, Venmo, Britic. You see, the thing that I wanted you all to experience on headphones was how the fucking song builds and builds and builds with each of these elements that you bring in when the mix is a full mix stem. Do you hear how fucking gorgeous it is? When these fucking, this is when the magic gets to be, I mean, I was experiencing, I was Bogart and all the magic myself. You guys were having fucking 33% of the experience. So now, man, you're getting to fucking hear this shit like build inside these headphones. Like you're getting to experience this fucking magical fucking music. Cheers, man. This is what I always wanted it to be for you. And my buddy Leo was listening to it, and he was like, dude, it's not just that it's in stereo. It's like there's also, like, the fidelity has been raised in some way, shape, or form, man. Y'all never got to hear that. You never got to hear this. The thought of the fact that everything that I'm playing is now in better fidelity and in stereo is just, it's perfection. It's perfection. It's perfection. This has become a perfect experience. This has become a perfect experience, man. If the Great Pumpkin wanted to give me, you know, because it's, I left that apartment after 22 years, man. I was really nervous. And I felt really weird. Like the first day I sat down here, I felt really weird. And the whole experience, I had considerable amounts of fear as to whether this would be able to keep going. And that's not an exaggeration, because if it wasn't going to be pleasant for me, then I couldn't do it. So I was really nervous. And the fact that we've all been given this unbelievable fucking gift, the transitioning from that room to this room has allowed us to have this experience together, where you are getting to receive this music in a way that for 18 months I never even thought for a minute that it was going to be possible. So the thought of everyone being able to put headphones on and just get this fucking medicine is a fucking gift, man. And I'm so fucking grateful and excited.
She's a good girl, loves her mama, loves Jesus in America too. She's a good girl, is crazy about Elvis, loves horses and her boyfriend too. And it's a long day living in Reseda. There's a freeway running through the yard. I'm a bad boy, 'cause I don't even miss her. I'm a bad boy for breaking her heart. I'm free, free falling. Yeah, I'm free, free falling. All the vampires walking through the valley, move west down Ventura Boulevard. And all the bad boys are standing in the shadows, and the good girls are home with broken hearts. I'm
out, everybody. Thank you so much. I'm going to continue to get emotional about this fucking stereo thing. It's so ridiculous. But I'm going to continue to get emotional about it until, you know, in about a week, I'll probably be over it. We can all move on. But sincerely, like, it's transformed the entire experience for me. And I couldn't be more happy for you to be able to really have, no one else is going to have this experience of it. Like, when the Spotify podcast happens and the TV show happens and all the other versions of this show happen, this version is going to be fucking so unique to us and to this. And the thought that after all of the struggle and the madness of the past fucking 18 months, we get to be here and then we get to have this old experience be reborn in a new house that is like the perfect fucking place for me right now, the perfect landing spot, is a housewarming gift that I couldn't have imagined. So for all of you that have hung out here, man, like, here's the payoff. Here's the payoff, man. Y'all earned it. Y'all earned it. Stuck through this nightmare that we've been through and stuck in and didn't cave. And now after all that, you get to have the experience that I wanted more than anything for all of you to get to have. Which is just to be able to hear these things the way I was getting to. And that is, that's amazing. So, thanks, everybody. MJ Wednesday tomorrow night. Don't know what song it's going to be. PYT sounds like a pretty fucking good way to go. Stereo PYT with the guitars on either side. I think that might have to be it, everybody. All right? So, I will see you all back here tomorrow night, 6 p.m. Pacific time for MJ Wednesday. Probably going to be PYT because we need to have the stereo version of PYT for you all to fucking experience. So, see you all back here tomorrow night. At 6 p.m. Pacific time. And then don't forget Thursday at fucking 6 p.m. Zach and Jim from fucking Jimmy at World are going to do the middle with us. And maybe we'll convince them to stick around and we'll do some fucking, Lucky Denver Mint as well. So I'll see you all back here tomorrow night. All right? Be calm, be cool, be collected, be safe, be nice to each other. And if you feel like donating, do so at thesessionwebsite.com or the Venmo, which is Brittick, B-R-I-T. D-I-C-K.